Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. On Thursday, SpaceX launched the Starlink 3-5 mission successfully on a Falcon 9 rocket.
2-1, engine full power, and lift off of Starlink 3-5. Go Falcon, go Starlink.
Vehicle is pitching downrange.
The booster which launched this mission, B-1061, then landed successfully for the 13th time on the drone ship Of Course I Still Love You.
Stage 1, landing burn.
Stage 2, terminal guidance.
And there's confirmation that stage 1 landing burn has started in preparation for landing on our drone ship Of Course I Still Love You in the Pacific.
Stage 1, landing leg deploy.
And there you saw on your screen, Falcon 9 has successfully landed on
stage
our drone ship.
Stage 1 landing confirmed.
On our drone ship, Of Course I Still Love You, in the Pacific Ocean. This marks our 187th overall landing of an orbital class rocket.
Expected loss of signal, Vandenberg.
Including Falcon 9 and Falcon Heavy missions.
Then, on Friday, SpaceX launched the O3B Empower 3 and 4 mission.
1, ignition, engine full power, and go. Falcon 9 and SES O3B Empower.
The booster which launched this mission, B-1078, then landed successfully for the second time on the drone ship Just Read the Instructions.
There was confirmation of second engine cutoff.
Nominal parking orbit insertion.
And a nominal orbital insertion.
Stage 1 landing burn.
There is the start of our stage 1 landing burn, and you can see that drone ship coming in quick.
Stage 1 landing leg deploy.
What an awesome view of that first stage recovery. Everyone's very excited here in Hawthorne. And there you have it. That landing marks SpaceX's 188th recovery of an orbital class rocket, including first stage landing of Falcon 9 and Heavy.
The Falcon Heavy mission has been delayed multiple times recently due to weather. It's currently scheduled to lift off tomorrow, Monday 1st at 12:26 a.m. UTC, or today, Sunday 30th at 8:26 p.m. EDT. We can hopefully expect to see the next Starlink launch this coming week. The Starlink 5-6 mission is scheduled to lift off on Tuesday 2nd at 8:02 a.m. UTC or 4:02 a.m. EDT. SpaceX posted this crazy image on Twitter a few days ago related to the Falcon Heavy vehicle. They said last night's storm in Florida produced hail, tornadoes, and lightning. Following this strike on the tower at 39A, teams performed additional checkouts of Falcon Heavy, the payloads, and ground support equipment. There was an article posted related to Starlink. It says Rogers Communications is partnering with SpaceX and Link Global to deliver satellite-to-phone connectivity across Canada and bolster coverage in remote regions. Heading to Boca Chica after the recent Starship flight test, Mary did a drive-by of the launch site where there's lots of damage. Here's a view of the Starbase orbital launch site after the Starship launch. Here's a view of the tank farm berm after the launch as well. As we saw last video, the chopsticks were lowered from their launch position. Work has begun on the orbital launch mount to inspect the damage and start fixing it. SpaceX are putting together a crane at the launch site. A crane in the production yard was seen lifting stuff up to the top of the mega bay. It appears that recently there was a fire at Massey's test site at Starbase. RGV Aerial Photography posted a picture on Twitter related to the fire. It says, "Figured out what was on fire at Massey's based on imagery we captured today. A telehandler, forklift, and multiple light towers are charred. This test nose cone was tested recently at Massey's test site." There was an interesting tweet posted by Jeff Faust with information from NASA Administrator Bill Nelson. It says, "Nelson says SpaceX has told NASA that it can repair the pad and prepare the next Starship in about 2 months. Last week's failure is not a big downer. Musk gave information about the launch of Starship in a Twitter Spaces discussion, and there are some tweets from Michael Sheets I want to share. The first says, Musk says, I'm glad to report that the pad damage is actually quite small and should be repaired quickly. There was another tweet saying, from a pad standpoint, we are probably ready to launch in 6 to 8 weeks. The longest item on that is probably requalification of the flight termination system. It took way too long to rupture the tanks. There was also information related to why Super Heavy launched with 3 engines out already. Musk said there were 3 engines that we chose not to start, so that's why Super Heavy Booster lifted off with 30 engines, which is the minimum number of engines. The 3 engines didn't explode but were just not healthy enough to bring them to full thrust, so they were shut down. There was also another tweet posted related to the loss of some engines during flight. It says, at T plus 27 seconds, SpaceX lost communications due to some kind of energy event. And some kind of explosion happened to knock out the heat shields of engines 17, 18, 19 or 20. Musk went on to explain what caused them to trigger the flight termination system. This tweet says, rocket kept going through T plus 62 seconds with the engines continuing to run, lost thrust vector control at T plus 85 seconds. For the next flight, Musk said, big thing for next Starship launch is ensuring that we don't lose thrust vector control with Booster 9. There was another tweet about Musk's expectations for the next flight. It says, my expectation for the next flight would be to reach orbit. Next flight profile will be a repeat. Musk gave information about Raptor production and SpaceX slowing down a bit with that. This tweet says, slowed down Raptor engine production because we've got more Raptors than we know what to do with. There was another interesting tweet posted saying, expect to spend around $2 billion this year on Starship. In another tweet, Musk said, SpaceX has yet to make a final decision on which Starship prototype and Super Heavy booster will fly the next launch. There were a couple more tweets posted related to the state of the orbital launch site. This one says, going to be replacing a bunch of tanks in the tank farm, but these are tanks that we wanted to replace anyway. Related to the tower, this tweet was posted. It says, tower itself is in good shape. We see no meaningful damage to the tower, even though they got hit with some pretty big chunks of concrete. The final tweet in this thread I want to share says, Elon Musk says he plans to do another Starship update in 3 weeks-ish. Work continues on the Ship 26 prototype at the Rocket Garden. The Ship 27 prototype was moved over to the Rocket Garden. Starship 28 was seen lifted in the high bay with a new lifting jig. The Booster 11 LOX tank was seen moving in the mega bay. To finish this video, I have to say thanks to Mary, otherwise known as Boca Chica Gal, Nick Ansuini and Jack Beyer for being out there filming the Starbase content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.